What year was Forbes founded? There you go. Forbes was founded in 1917. At Brilliant Labs, we build augmented reality devices at the confluence of AR hardware and generative AI, with everything being perfectly open source. We started the company because we saw a lot of headsets in the market that were quite large, quite heavy, and quite expensive. But more importantly, we saw a lack of ingenuity, a lack of innovation in the software being built for a lot of these platforms. So we started the company with a really different vision, and that was you need to do AR hardware that is light, pocket size, totally open source, but you also have to do software or integrations with software that are primarily AI focused as the enabler for this next generation of computing. Monocle is a pocket-sized, totally open source AR device that clips onto a pair of glasses. It has a range of sensors like capacitive touch, a microphone, camera, and a bunch of processors. And that means that it's a great platform for developers to begin experimenting with all kinds of rich software applications at the intersection of augmented reality and generative AI.
What's a good wine for a hot summer's day? Pinot Grigio?
Lovely.
Sounds good.
Hey Varun, I hear you're looking for a job to teach React Native.
Thank you for your interest. I've been studying React Native for the past few months, and I'm confident that I have the skills and knowledge access necessary for the job.
We've done a mobile app for both iOS and Android called Noah. It's got a range of an increasing number of generative AI offerings within the app that developers can experiment with. So one is GPT. We have a stability API integration. Speak a voice command. Monocle's camera will take in an image and regenerate that image. Turn these into a bunch of robots. Another one is live translation using the Whisper API.
今天开会怎么样?
They just came back in Chinese. Oh, you know what? It's not printing properly.
We're working on the world's thinnest and lightest AR device that maintains the completely open source value proposition, but takes the AI side of things one leap forward in terms of enabling AI not only to handle your natural language prompts, but also take images and audio from the device to potentially even prompt you as you navigate life. In the next 5 years, if we're successful at doing what we're currently trying to do, we would have a device which is as beautiful to wear and useful such that it becomes this secondary mind, this co-pilot, helping you navigate your daily life. I guess put a different way, it would be a reconceptualization of what we think of as glasses.